current live stream schedule is Sunday mornings at 10 o'clock a.m. and Tuesday night Bible class at 7 o'clock p.m. You may watch live on YouTube or Facebook under the Christ Temple Christian Life Center page. Our new prayer line number that is open during both of these services is 1-833-PRAY-CTC. That's 1-833-772-9282. Ways to give. You can download the Givelify app and search for Christ Temple Christian Life Center. You may also give via Cash App, mail your gifts to the church, or you may call Deacon Reed at 502-442-3174 anytime during normal business hours. Here are four simple ways to share this live stream. The easiest is to just click the share button. No matter where we are in the service, this is the fastest way to get our service out to everyone. You can also copy and share the website link by text or email, start a watch party on Facebook, or simply tag three friends in the comment section. Let's stay connected daily through prayer. Join us every morning from 7 to 7:30 a.m. via the Christ Temple CLC Facebook page as we pray together as a church family in unity. And now for this week's announcements. To our Bishop Michael E. Ford Jr., First Lady Andrea Ford, Elder Williams, Pastor Reed, and our entire CTCLC family, there really aren't enough words to express how appreciative we are of the love and support shown us during the passing of our beloved Christopher Mays. Thank you for covering us with much-needed prayer, words of encouragement, flowers, visits, monetary gifts, food, and cards. May God bless each of you for your great kindness to us. We love you. Thanks for everything from the Mays family. To my CTCLC pastor and church family, the love and caring comes naturally with my Christ Temple Church family. Thank you for your prayers and visitation with our brother and father while in the hospital and nursing home. And thank you for the food, cards, and other acts of kindness during the loss of our brother and father. May God richly bless each of you. With love, the siblings and entire family of Deacon Lawrence Chandler. There will be a mandatory usher board meeting on Saturday, November the 11th. At 12 o'clock noon. All ushers, please plan now to attend. Our annual Thanksgiving food drive is going on now through November 17th. Donations should include canned and boxed goods. For a list of suggested items, please check the email blast. All sisters are invited to our annual Women's Growth Conference, November 17th through the 19th. Register today and let us know you will be attending by downloading the photo frame and posting to social media. Please check the email blast for more details, including our attire for the weekend. Mark your calendars now and plan to invite everyone you know to our Family and Friends Day. Join us on Sunday, November 26th at 10 o'clock a.m. And lastly, have you shared today? If not, go ahead and take this moment to share this live stream with your family and friends. Remember, we are the church. Thank you for your attention, everyone.
We're here, amen, to start out this morning and come and let us set the atmosphere, the spiritual atmosphere for the assembly today.
We have something
as we honor the Lord and His presence. We've not been together in a week, and this is another day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Those of you that will, come join me here at the altar as we begin to cry out unto Him.
Please
come quickly, 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 come. We didn't just come to sit. We came to honor and to bless the Lord with His presence. We come to give thanks, and we come to bless Him for all of His goodness toward us. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Let us all say amen and amen.
Come on, don't stop there. Come on, don't stop there. Come on, don't stop there. Come on, come on, come on. Open up your mouth and give him praise. Somebody give him praise. Somebody lift up your voice like a trumpet. Come on, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, you in live stream. Come on, just open up your mouth and give God praise right where you are. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm reminded in Exodus chapter 24 when God came down to Mount Sinai, and the Bible said that the cloud came down and rested on the top of the mountain. And Moses waited for God to call his name. And he waited outside the glory cloud. I want y'all just to understand that God is here. Wait for him to call your name. Open up your mouth. Get his attention. Come on, open up your mouth. Get his attention. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, he's calling your name. Come on, somebody say your name. Come on, say your name. Come on, God's calling your name right now. He's giving you revelation. He's giving you healing. He's letting his glory abide in your temple. Come on, somebody open up your mouth right now. Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on, come on. Open up your mouth right here. God, you're a merciful God, and your mercy endures forever. Your grace is good for us, God. Your grace is sufficient to us, oh God. And so, God, we praise you for your grace. We praise you for your faithfulness. We praise you for your mercy. We praise you for all the great attributes. God, we restore greatness to your name. Somebody, open up your mouth. Let it flow from your heart. Open up your mouth and give him praise that's due to his name. Somebody become grateful for the fact that he woke you up this morning, started you on your way. You might not have the best condition right now, but just be grateful. Somebody lift your voices right here. Somebody say, let the glory of the Lord rise among them. Come on, somebody say, let the glory of the Lord rise among them. How do you get his glory? Give him praise right here. Somebody open up your mouth and shout. Some say, let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Yeah, let me say it again. Say, let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Come on, lift those hands. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. And let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. We shall, oh, song says, oh, I see y'all. Let it rise. Come on, I want y'all to breathe in and out. Y'all say, oh. Somebody say, let it rise. Come on, y'all, lift your hands right here. Yeah, 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 yeah. Jesus. See the crowd running down on the hill. His glory is here. His healing is here. His faithfulness is here. His joy is here. Hey, somebody clap those hands right. Oh, I need y'all to open up your mouth this time. Somebody open up your mouth right here. Hey, let me say right here. Say, let your glory rise among us. Let your glory rise among us. See, let your glory rise among us. Let your glory rise among us. Say, let your glory
Now everybody clap those. presence of God, what do you do in his presence? Come on and show me, what do you do in the presence of God? Well, because he is alive and he is well, can you just take 30 seconds and just offer him the praise, whether it's praise. Worship your best praise. The glory of the Lord is here. And the glory of the Lord is here. Come on and offer him something. Offer him more than what you gave him last Sunday. Offer him more than what you have given him last week. Come on and offer him the fruits of your lips. Come on and let's be the example of what it looks like to glorify the Lord. Come on, if you're not too pretty, if you're not too sharp, if you're not too masculine, if you're not too dainty, come on, the glory of the Lord is in this house. We acknowledge him and we acknowledge his presence. He is the Lord, strong and mighty. He is the Lord mighty in battle. Oh, taste and see that he is good. His mercy endureth forever, and his truth is everlasting. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us do it together. Exalt his name together and forever. We will glorify the name of the Lord, the matchless Savior, the risen King. Shekinah is in this place, and we bless his name. We worship Christ, our Lord. We worship Christ, our Lord. We lift our hands to him today, and we worship Christ, Lord. We worship. Come on, sing it with me. Worship Christ, our Lord. We worship Christ, Christ our Lord. Hey, glory to your name. Let's do it together. We lift our hands to him today. In the courtroom, yes, my Lord, he's a doctor in a sick room, yes, my Lord, he makes ways out of no ways, you say yes. Feel a heavy anointing in here. My Lord. He's been my father when I felt fatherless. Yes. My Lord. And some of you all might have lost a mother. He's a mother. Yes, he is. Yes. My Lord. He's way out of nowhere. Brain. You all say it. Say yes.
Yes.
My Lord. He's a God that answers prayer.
Yes.
My Lord. Say, oh, yes. My Lord. Yes, my Lord. Oh, yes, my Lord.
Can I testify for a few minutes? Just this past week. Just this past week, my cousins were in a very, very fatal accident. The driver, they were in their lane. The driver was coming at 100 miles per an hour. His car was divided in half. The truck was smashed almost all the way in two. There were six kids inside of the car, and their father was driving the car. And he said, well, if I turn my car this way, because I know I can't miss him because he's driving so fast and he lost control. But if I turn this way, I could take most of the impact. And if something happens to me, they'll live. Well, he made the decision as quickly as he could. And when he made that decision, it was still bad. Every single one of them had one broken arm and one broken foot. They had to go into immediate surgery within the next couple of days. But there was the one baby, Sebastian, who took the most impact of the hit. They had to operate on him and take part of his skull out, the bone in there. And so he began to, we would say, fight for his life. And when I walked inside the hospital room, he was wiggling his toes. He was trying to take things off because he could still hear. So God began to heal the rest of the family. He's still in the hospital going through his therapy. But if I can't think of another reason to give the Lord the praise, when I looked at the car and saw how the car looked, they were not supposed to live. And I walked inside the hospital room and I said, thank you, Jesus. I said, thank you, Jesus. I walked out of another room and went into another room. I said, thank you, Jesus. I walked out of that room and went to another room and I said, thank you, Jesus. Then I got inside of Sebastian's room, the one who had the most impact, and I said, thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. So he is the lily of the valley. He is the bright and morning star. He is the true and wise and living Savior. He is the Lord Most High. He is a healer. Somebody was in the sick room just yesterday with bleeding on the brain, and that baby had bleeding on the brain. But guess what? He's going through therapy and he's doing a lot better. God is a healer and the world still don't believe it. I said God is a healer and the world still don't believe it. Somebody lift your voice and say, he's a healer. He's a healer. He's a healer. He's a healer.
Thank you.
Jesus. He answers. Jesus means Savior. And when I call on my Savior, He hears and He answers prayer. In the time of trouble, God hides me under the shadow of His wing. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, He's a healer. In the world, don't believe it. Now somebody said, this supposed to be praise and worship. Well, it is.
We overcome.
Look at the person behind you and say, this is praise and worship. The Bible says, I want y'all to finish it. They were overcome. Shout it out again. They were overcome. I got one more testimony, all right? Do y'all want to hear it? Let me see you wave your hand if you want to hear it. While God is in the healing business, there's a young lady here. I grew up with her family. Her brother is sitting on the organ.
Glory, 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 glory. He's a healer.
Let her feet testify. So listen. So look, she came here a few months ago, and the power of God was moving in the room. And she walked up. I didn't know what was going on with her. I just said, you know what? That's Nisha. She came here and laid out across the altar. Y'all were gone. Y'all were doing something else. But she was in the presence of the Most High God and with the saints. So she came and laid right here on the altar. And I went down, and the Lord led me to pray for her. I went down. We were just praying. I didn't know what I was praying for. But listen, y'all. This woman has stage 4 cancer. Y'all don't want to hear about no miracle. She has stage 4 cancer. Again, I didn't know it. We were just in the presence of God. She went into the hospital and went to go get her report, y'all. Y'all tell me what you think happened.
Healer.
Tell me what you think happened. She was inside this house. While all of this was going on, she went back and got a check from stage 4 cancer. So in other words, she was supposed to die, right? But God said, not so. God said, not so. God said, there she is right there. Somebody help her.
House of miracles.
Somebody help her. Praise God. Come on, Christ Temple. Somebody help her praise God. Somebody help them. Now, if it was your family, you'd be running down the aisle too. If it was your cousin, you'd be running down the aisle too. Somebody shout, God is a healer. 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 Shiana. Come on, somebody help her praise Him. Somebody help her praise Him. Y'all come help her praise Him.
We believe your power.
Come on and help her praise Him.
We believe your miracle.
Come on, somebody help her praise Him. God is a miracle worker. What do you do when God do something for you? What do you do when God do something special for you? She beat death. She beat the report of the doctors. Whose reports shall you believe? We shall believe the report of the Lord. We shall believe the report of the Lord. His report says, I am healed. His report says, I am free. His report says, victory. Whose report shall you believe? We shall. We shall. We shall. We shall. We shall believe the report of the Lord. And guess what else? Her name is on that wall back there. So all of your prayers, all of your prayers, all of our prayers have been answered. Lift your hands and let's glorify the Lord. Come on. Come on. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Healing
to the If you know somebody else, and we got to go. If you know somebody else that need healing, right now.
Come on.
Right now.
Come on.
Go into intercession for the person who you believe in God for. Right now. And if God can do it for her, He can do it for them. Lift your hands and go for it. Come on, lift your hands and your voice and go for it. Come on. Now, can we take a moment and just worship the Lord for what He's done? It is of the Lord's doing. And it is marvelous in our eyes. Hallelujah. He's the lily in the valley. Yes. My Lord. Say it with me. He's the lawyer in the courtroom. Say yes. My Lord. He's the doctor in the sick room. Yeah. Oh, my Lord. He's the healer of cancer. We say yes. My Lord. Oh, yes.
Wonderful, wonderful testimony of God's grace and His mercy unto us. Son, we are blessed, we are blessed, we are blessed, we are blessed, we are blessed. We are blessed, we are blessed. Let's be seated for just a moment. God is a healer. The world won't recognize it, but He is. He's a deliverer. And God certainly honors us today with a great testimony. We've been praying for many days, expecting miracles. We're expecting miracles. And certainly our Lord has provided. Now, she's not the only one. I'm sure there are others in here that want to tell their testimony too. And God's going to give you a chance. As a matter of fact, our strategic planning is planning some of this stuff. We're going to have testimonies, and they're going to be inputted into the service. Amen. Deliverance from car crashes, deliverance from cancers, deliverances that, amen, only we can know about. He's a wonder in our souls. He's a wonder, He's a wonder, He's a wonder. Our time to bless the house of the Lord with our gift and our giving. Here it is, just 5 days past the first of the month. Many of you, if you're my age, our good old uncle gave us a piece of money, and certainly He gave it to us, and the Bible talks about honoring God with the first fruits of all your increase. Tithing is not only a part of my life, but will always be a part of my life. Whatever God gives me, automatically give Him back the portion, and then the rest God allows me to spend, amen, under my own will. But certainly we want to honor the Lord's house today, and for those of you, if you need an envelope for your giving, those of you that are watching Christ Temple Christian Life Center, that's our Cash App, and Givelify, you can also, amen, call the church, amen, and talk to Deacon Reed. Now, one of the things that we want to be sure to do is we also amen, take care of many things, not only here in Louisville, but around the country and around the world. And we want to be faithful in our giving. Faithfulness is a part of being saved. Amen. Without faith and faithfulness, amen, we will not get what we're supposed to get from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And so those of you that are ready, if you're ready, if you have your electronic amen, we also have receptacles around the auditorium, and you can give it to amen, and they will take care of it. Amen. So those of you that are ready to give, amen, let's hold up our offering envelopes. And those of you that have electronic giving, please hold them up. Let's pray and ask God's blessings over what you have brought today. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we're so thankful for your loving kindness and tender mercies unto us. Lord, we thank you for what you have provided, Lord, and what you're doing in our lives. We ask now, oh God, that you receive, oh God, our gifting, our tithing, and our offering. Let it be used to your glory and to your honor. Oh God, I pray that you'll return it, oh God, to the givers, oh God, and bless those that don't have, Lord, to have to give. Open doors and provide the opportunities for economics. And Lord, we'll give your name all praise, all honor, all glory is thine. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our young people are coming first, and then after, amen, our deacons will walk the aisle. Amen. Our connect team is coming.
Hello, my name is Leah. I'm a member of the Connect team, and I welcome you to Christ Temple. This is the House of Miracles. Whether you are here in person or online, I hope you feel the presence of the Lord today. Be prepared to hear a message from Pastor Pamela Reed that will challenge, encourage, and strengthen your faith. Christ Temple is where your healing takes place and your deliverance too. Contact us if you're in search for a church home. We can't wait to see you. Now enjoy the rest of the service. May God bless you.
See if you real quick and just tell God thank you.
Thank you.
Come on, tell God thank you.
Thank you.
Come on, lift those hands in the sanctuary. Come on, somebody say thank you, Lord, for your presence.
Thank you, Lord, for your
anybody
presence.
Want more of God? I said, anybody want more of God?
Yes, Lord. Yeah, yeah.
Do y'all want more of God?
Yes.
Somebody make some noise for Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for his healing. Thank you for his faithfulness. Thank you for everything. Now, everybody clap those hands right. Two, one. Everybody clap those hands right. Come on. Oh, God, we lift your name up on high because you are a healer. You are a way maker. You are a sustainer. Everything that you do for us, you do well. And so that's the reason why. We lift our hands. Everybody say, we lift our
hands. We lift our hands in the
come on, church.
Sanctuary.
We lift our hands.
We lift our hands.
Come on, lift them up,
to
y'all.
To give you the glory.
We lift our hands.
We lift our hands to give you
come
the
on this side. I need y'all to get it. Hey.
And we will praise you for the rest of our
somebody
day.
Somebody say yes.
Yes. We will praise you for
one
the rest
time.
Of
say.
Our day.
We lift our hands.
Lord.
Yes, Lord.
For the rest. Say yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
All together. just got a sneaky suspicion. I just got this little feeling that everything is gonna be all right.
Yeah.
to loose. Those testimonies this morning were to turn your faith up.
Turn your faith up.
My God, Elder Will, I know you're praying for me. Y'all keep seeing. Y'all can't get to the... You keep messing with me.
Hallelujah.
James Jones just got the Holy Ghost.
Uh-oh.
Back in Deacon, re-deacon, Cheatham Thompson. I want to get baptized. So mama said, well, maybe next Sunday. He said, but it was the day that Bishop preached. Today might be the day. He said, God might come today.
Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost.
He's like 5 years old. Holy he looked Ghost. Like he's three. Holy so Ghost. Then he comes down. He talks to Sister Nikki on the connect. And she said, well, you know, with why don't we wait till next Sunday? He said, oh, my God, he might come today. Sister Nikki said, get that boy ready. Daddy done got the Holy Ghost. He's the leader of the pack. He's the head of the family.
That's right.
Everybody else, get in line.
Rivers of living water.
Woo!
Rivers.
Rivers.
Of living water.
Y'all sit
rivers
down.
Of living water. Hey, rivers. Woo! Of living water. Rivers.
Y'all gonna get me in trouble.
Living water.
Y'all sit down. This is the house of the healed.
Yes, it is.
This is the house of disciples. The house of doers, the house of the wealthy. Put our confession up. Lord, give me enough strength. I am the church of Jesus Christ, and the kingdom of God is in me. Today I openly receive the word of God that I may be empowered to live and minister Jesus to my family, to my community, and to this generation. Woo. Let me get my
living water. Y'all say,
give me no trouble. Praise, give, and honor to Jesus Christ, our Lord and our soon coming King, the lover of my soul, the keeper of my entire being. I give honor to our pastor, Bishop Michael E. Ford Jr., and to his luxurious, fragrance Lady Andrea, and their five stars. Oh, my God, bless two to me. To our assistant pastor, Dishagelda Williams, and to his faithful wife, Minister Natasha Williams, and to my husband, my man, Deacon James W. Reed Jr., to my little brother who raised me in holiness. It really is all I know, and I'm blessed for it. And to you, the greatest people, know this, that you are the greatest people on the face of this earth. We give you honor this morning. Whether you've joined us in person or online, we greet you in the name of Jesus. My soul, I'm not going to sing it, but my soul loves Jesus. And my soul seeks to please him. We done had some church this morning. When I came through that back door, I felt it. I felt engulfed by the praises, the Zion that were going forth. And just for a few moments, it's a good thing. It's not a long message. It's just something that the Lord told me, gave to me to give to you this morning. Then we're going to sit on down, get out the way somewhere. In the book of Luke chapter 16. Woo, see, Minister Hooker, the hook just keeps on. My God. The Bible says, but Abraham said, child, remember that in your lifetime, you got the good things. Lazarus got the bad things. It's not like that here. Here he is consoled and you are tormented. Beside in all these matters, there's a huge chasm, which is a break in wherever you are to where the next person is, set between us so that no one can go from us to you, even if he wanted to. Nor can anyone cross over from you to us. Romans 8 and 18. Worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. And then John on the Isle of Patmos says, and I saw a new heaven and a new earth. You know, we've traveled this path before. Bishop told us on congregational meetings the other night that sometimes we need a reminder, and some have not so much as heard it. You know, the word of God is quick, it's powerful, it's sharper than any two-edged sword, you know, meaning it as it points outward to you, the other end is pointing at me. And I will not offer you the edged sword without falling on it myself. Amen. For it to cut me and to heal me. So the subject this morning, just for a short while, do you prefer smoking or non-smoking? Prefer. It means to like, to choose, or to want one thing rather than the other. You might say, you know, I prefer that you don't smoke in my house or in my car. I prefer to watch football as to watch basketball. I prefer not to discuss this issue. The phrase smoking or non-smoking is commonly used in the context of asking someone's preference for a smoking or non-smoking section. You know, in a restaurant or other public place, it originated from a time when smoking was allowed in many public establishments, and there were designated areas for smokers and non-smokers. This question was asked to determine where a person would like to sit, you know, to avoid secondhand smoke. How many of you ever had secondhand smoke? It's horrible. Make you cough. Make you want to get up and move. And ain't no more seats nowhere. So many people prefer this non-smoking area just to avoid health risks that are associated with exposure to secondhand smoke, like lung disease, heart disease, SIDS. When you're having children, they could come up with sudden infant syndrome, which is why such options are often available in public places to accommodate different preferences. You know, in recent years, the smoking regulations have become more stringent in places, with smoking often prohibited in public places now to protect the health and well-being of non-smokers. You know, sometimes when you go to restaurants, you see the employees there outside smoking. Particularly restaurants are the ones I pay most attention to, because I don't know if you washed your hands when you went back inside. That part right there. You know, I don't know if your hands were on the ground. I'm telling you, if you went in and sanitized before you start handling my food, you know, my salmon and my broccoli and my baked potato. Tobacco smoke has more than 4,000 chemical compounds. At least 250 of them are known to cause disease. Isn't that horrible? So it raises the risk by as much as about 30% that others will get lung cancer and many other types of cancer, but God is a healer. And it can lead to emphysema, and it's bad for your heart. You know, some of you will remember that. If you're old enough, you will remember when you went in, they did ask you, would you like smoking or non-smoking? You know, things are different in the smoking area. Back in the day when we would go in, folks acted different in the smoking section. There's a lot of loud talking and belly gutting, and they not only were they smoking, it's likely they were drinking. You know, they were cussing. It was just a different kind of a vibe. That's what the young people say. Different kind of a vibe. When we went over to the non-smoking section, people were a little bit more sophisticated. It's a little bit more, you know, at themselves. You even know, you would know even now, getting insurance, they have a non-smoker price and they have a smoking price. And the quotes can be phenomenal if you are a smoker, because they assume that not too many days hence, you're going to be using their services. You get insurance quotes from AAA, from Globe Life, Transamerica, AARP. They consider you a high risk. So when you think about the diseases and what tobacco can do to your health, it ought to make you think. Okay, so I think you get the picture. All right, all right. So this is a good place to segue into our lesson text. This morning, we come up on a parable of Jesus in the Gospel of Luke concerning the rich man and Lazarus. I'm not telling you, it's 11:08, we won't be here that long. So there once was a rich man, and he was expensively dressed. You know, he had the latest fashions, the Gucci, you know, the Michael Kors, the Hermes, he was rich. He was what they call filthy rich. The party was waiting on him to get there, because things didn't really get started until he got there. And they had the best food. They had the best hors d'oeuvres. They came around and served him because he was the rich man. But there was he was so rich, he had gates on his compound, and they would lay beggars there who would beg the people that came in and out just for a crumb. Until there was this man that Jesus speaks about by the name of Lazarus, and the Bible says he was covered with sores, and he had been dumped on the doorstep of the rich man. So when the rich man comes to go in, he gets his attention, and he says, all I live for is to get some scraps off of your table.
And all he got back from the rich man was a sneer. The Bible says that even the dogs came. That was his only consolation. The dogs came and licked his sores. I can't talk about dogs too long. I have to send some tissue back there on the left side, on my right. And so the dogs licked him. And one day, this man was so, the sores were so bad. You know, after a while, if the sore is not treated, it will putrefy and it would just start oozing out. And it just is from head to toe, just sores everywhere. His breath was stinking like a toilet. He wasn't one that you wanted to come up on, and you just certainly didn't want him to come up on you. You know, bad situation. And so the Bible says that this poor man died and was taken up by the angels to the lap of Abraham. How about that? And then the Bible says that the rich man, he also died, and he was buried. You know, he probably had a nice, hefty life insurance policy. You know, they could call the best mortuary in the city. There were people around his bed to bid him farewell as he died. But Lazarus, the poor beggar, is outside. He doesn't have anybody to see about him, no sons, no daughters. His mama wasn't there. His daddy wasn't there. He was just a poor man. But when he died, the Bible clearly says that he was taken up by the angels to the lap of Abraham. So the rich man dies and he has all the pomp and circumstance. They march him down and they lay him out. His flowers everywhere because he's the rich man. And the Bible says that when he went to open his eyes, he looked up and in hell he did lift up his eyes. And he was in what Bishop Ford calls torment forever and ever. But from a distance he looks off and he sees Father Abraham in the distance, and he sees Lazarus with Father Abraham, and he calls out and says, Father Abraham, have mercy on me. I just want you to send Lazarus to dip his finger in water, just a little bit of water that he might cool my tongue. So I'm in agony in this fire. But Abraham reminded him, remember, in your lifetime, you got all the good things. Lazarus got the bad things. Well, it's not like that here because Lazarus is now consoled and you are tormented. Besides in all this, there's a great chasm between us. So the rich man, he begins to bargain with Abraham. And he says, then let me ask you this thing. If you would send Lazarus to the house of my father, because I got 5 brothers. How many of you got some folks in your family you want to see saved? He said, I just want him to tell them the score and warn them so they won't end up here in this place of torment. And Abraham, in all his wisdom, because he's already laying in paradise just waiting, they're waiting on us. And Abraham says, they have Moses, they have the prophets to tell them the score. Let them listen to them. Well, I know, Father Abraham, but if you send somebody from the dead, they will believe. And Abraham said, if they won't listen to Moses and the prophets, they certainly not going to be convinced by somebody who came from the dead. They're just going to think they've seen a ghost. So sometimes we ask, what do I get? You know, Lazarus is in the non-smoking section. And the rich man is in the smoking section. Ain't that for you, sir? But sometimes we think, what do we get for the sacrifice and the suffering? It's like we sacrifice so much, we suffer so much, and they go hand in hand. But, you know, all of us want to get paid for what we do. If it's just a simple thank you, a heartfelt thank you, we want to know that what we did mattered and that we were appreciated. What do I get for suffering like this? So when I say suffering, I mean when I want to participate in road rage. You know, we want to pull up on the side of someone and give them the finger and a piece of our minds. And what do I get for holding the beast inside of me because of Jesus? He constrains me. The Holy Ghost, he's in there. He constrains. We just got to listen to him. constrains me. You know, when I say suffering, I'm talking about when I'm unmarried and my body is aching for adult exercises, and I resist the temptation. What do I get for not satisfying my flesh? What do I get for not tipping outside of my marriage and committing adultery? What do I get for that? Maybe just one time. And is it going to hurt just one time? What do I get for not cheating on my tax return? You know, I could have checked that box and got an extra $2,000. What do I get for not doing that? What do I get for passing on this insatiable desire to smoke and inhale the nicotine that I have become so addicted and accustomed to? You know, nicotine is extremely addictive. Somebody gonna get healed. Somebody gonna get delivered from nicotine this morning. I know. Anything you starve will die. But I just want it. I just want this. Just do one time. Just if I could just smoke on Wednesdays, I think I'd be all right. That carry me through until next Wednesday. You know, what do I get for resisting that temptation? What do I get? What do I get for not lying, telling those lies when the Bible says that, and all liars shall have their part in the lake? What do I get for not being mean and nasty and jealous and gossip? What am I going to get for that when I can satisfy my flesh right now? What do I get for living clean, living without being carnal? What do I get for not hating others? You know, some folks that just hate on you, literally for no reason. That part, they just hate on you. What do I get? What do I get for not envying and not getting drunk? You know, the drunkenness helps me to forget the day's woes and the things that happened 10 years ago, but it's also a truth serum. So when you drink and you hear those folks talking, that it's just a truth serum. So everything in there, it starts to come out. That's the real them. I promise you, that's the real them. So what do I get? It's a daunting thought that I'm going to pass up everything in this earth and not know what I'm going to get. You know how kids are, they want to know what they're going to get. You know, you give them, no, I'm going to get $20 for my birthday. And sometimes you give them a little bonus. You give them an extra 20. Then they got 40. That surprises them. And that's sort of the way I think God does here in the book of Revelation. So let's segue to, I'm almost finished. Let's segue to Revelation 21. You know, time will not permit me to tell you all of it. And I believe God's got some rewards that I didn't even mention here. You know how your children, again, they're expecting just a little and you give them a lot. Well, we come across John the Apostle. He's the last of the apostles to die. He's the apostle that was charged to take care of Mary, the mother of Jesus. And for years, we didn't hear anything about him. Literally, he disappeared from Scripture. All of a sudden, he's very vocal about the Roman Empire. And we find him being banished to the Isle of Patmos. Little island that's over there in Greece. For many years, you know, God gave him, while he's there on that island, God gave him the final blueprint for the events that are going to close out this dispensation. He was also given the plan, guess what, for our compensation. For what we gonna get. So how does this sound for your reward, for your recompense? You gotta get paid. You know, all this pro bono, only the rich and wealthy do pro bono work. Folks who say they're doing it for free, not really. They just doing it free to a point. They just hoping that you'll get it, that eventually you'll slip me a little something. You know, it just kind of evens the playing ground. It evens the playing ground. And so in the book of Revelation, chapter number 21, he's gone through the first chapter. He tells you how he got there. He turns around. He sees the Father. He said he's got hair like lamb's wool. It was a beautiful presentation that God gave him to give to us. I want you to know, people of God, this is not a fairy tale. It's not a fairy tale that the Middle East is in an uproar. It's not a fairy tale that we should be watching Israel. Is that part? It is not a fairy tale. This is truth, people of God. This is truth. So the Apostle John says, after all of the previous 20 chapters, he says, I saw a new heaven and a new earth. Guess what? That's part of what you're going to get. You're going to get a new heaven and a new earth. It won't be nothing like Louisville, Kentucky. My God, in the name of Jesus. Why would I want to dismiss from all of this stuff that I could do, that I could satisfy my flesh, and not get something that doesn't look like Louisville, Kentucky? Rapes and robberies, and every day you wake up, you just wonder who got killed today. Or how many were killed today? How many were murdered today? Did we lose a police officer? How many fires today? Who got fired today from the JCPS for fooling with children? And the ones they haven't called yet. Anyway, pray on your children before they go to school. He said, I saw a new heaven and a new earth, because the first heaven and the first earth were passed away. And then guess what he says we're going to get? No more seas. Can you imagine no more hurricanes? No more tsunamis? No more tropical cyclones? No more monster waves? No more typhoons? No more billowing waves? You are going to inherit that. That's part of your compensation package. Better than 401k. Better than the six-figure salary. Better than health insurance. For you and your family, better than overtime. Yeah, then he says, I, John. See, he definitely identifies himself. I saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. He said, and I heard a great voice behind me. And the good thing about it is that God is going to be with us. Do you ever try to imagine in your mind what he looks like? What his presence feel like to be right there with him? And in verse number 4, he says, this is part of your compensation plan. I mean, you might want to write this down. This is good stuff. He says, God's going to wipe away all tears. You know, these ducts that we have under our eyes, they're always crying because they keep your eyes moist. It's when your emotions flow over that the tears flow out. So he's going to wipe all tears away. Can you imagine being in a situation where there are no more tears? Well, the next part of your compensation plan is no more death. No more. We appreciate A.D. Porter, G.C. Williams, newcomers, Arch L. Hetty, Hathaway and Clark, and we appreciate their services. We appreciate Jonathan and we appreciate Jeff, you know, but we won't need them anymore. No more death. I won't have to write another resolution. We won't have to send no flowers from Nance and Kraft. No more death. No more death. No more sorrow. You know, you can get up and it's a good day. About 12 o'clock, 1, 2, you don't know what kind of news you're going to hear to bring sorrow to your heart. No more sorrow, no more crying. And this one I love, no more pain. My God, can you imagine a world being in a city where there is no pain? There's no headaches. There's no sinuses, no allergies. Can you imagine? Every other person in here has allergies. We live in the Ohio Valley. No more pain. No more pain in your knees. Somebody ought to say, thank you, Jesus. No more pain in your backbone. My God, you sleep wrong. You got pain in your neck. You got a crook. I woke up this morning. I was like, no, let me see other wind. I don't know. You know, no more pain. No more pain in your foot. Sometimes your eyes hurt. You know, there's only a certain amount of time that your eyes, that's right, Doc. Only a certain amount of time that your eyes are supposed to be open. You're supposed to close your eyes so they can rest. Yes, thank you for the rest. No more pain. No more toothaches. None. Not just, well, we might have a little bit. No, no more. This is part of your compensation package. Then he says, and it is so much that we don't even know that I can't even express to you this morning that there's going to be a fountain of the water of life. So there, it will be no more need for LG&E. My God, with them $300 bills, they're getting ready to start getting together. No more Louisville Water Company. We won't need the light because he will be the light of the city. He gonna light the city. So when you're overcoming all of those things, you're gonna inherit all things. Yeah, and then John goes on down and he begins to talk about how he got carried away in the spirit to a high mountain and how he showed him that great city, the Holy Jerusalem. And he talks about the city itself. You've not seen anything quite like it. And I don't know that I can do it justice, but the city was, the light was like a stone most precious, like a jasper stone. And it was clear as crystal. And then it had these great high walls and had 12 gates in the city. And at the gates, there were 12 angels, and the names were written, which were the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel. So he says, on the east, there were three gates. This is come. This ain't like living in Sanctuary Bluff. This ain't like living in Prospect. This ain't living in Lake Forest. This is, I mean, if your husband wasn't able to get you those things, don't worry about it. You got a mansion coming that your mind can't even, on this side, your mind can't even hold it. There's three gates on the north, three gates on the south, and three gates on the west. And then he says that the wall of that city had 12 foundations. We marvel when we see a three-story house. Whether you have a ranch on a basement, or whether you have a three-story, or whether you have a South Fork spread or whatever, he says, this city had 12 foundations. And in them, the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. So he says that the city was so massive as it came down that the angel measured the city with a reed, and it was 12,000 furlongs. The city was 1,500 miles. 1,500 miles. So he measures it. This city is massive. I mean, this is part of your compensation package. I want you to know what you're going to get. What are you going to get for not participating in road rage and adult exercises? Something about that building. The Bible says that the wall of it was jasper and the city was pure gold. You've not seen gold like this. I know they have gold in different areas in our country, but you've not seen gold like this. The Bible says it was like clear glass. So the foundations of the wall of the city were garnished with all of these precious stones. Again, the first was jasper. The second was sapphire. The third was chalcedony, and the fourth was an emerald. You've seen an emerald before. It's like that green color. But you don't have to worry. You go on and enjoy your apartment. Enjoy your condo. Enjoy your patio home. Enjoy your bi-level home. Enjoy it. It's what God gave you for here. Enjoy your three-story, your single-family home with, and your ranch on a basement. Enjoy, but you ain't seen nothing yet. I mean, you ain't seen nothing yet. We need to be reminded that this is not an exercise. Living holy is not an exercise in futility. It is. So he says the fifth floor is sardonyx, and the sixth is sardius, and the seventh is chrysolite, and the eighth is beryl, and the ninth is topaz. How many of you can say that that's the way the floors in your house look? The 10th, the 11th, a jacinth, and the 12th, an amethyst. So just don't worry about it. Don't worry about it if all your husband could afford was simulated diamonds or cubic zirconium. It's all right. Show it off, honey. It's a process of the covenant that you and he have. So he talks about the 12 gates, and the 12 gates were 12 pearls. Every several gates was just one pearl. You know, and folks try to make you feel bad. You hear that stuff? You know, I used to work at this store, and the girl told me, she said, and the next, she came over and she said, are you apostolic? Apostolic. And I said, yes. I thought you was in that mess. Honey, it's the best mess I ever been in. Don't play. Don't play with me. This is the best mess. Because I know in the end, we're going to win. In the end, I'm going to say how I got over. My soul looks back and wonder how I get over. Talks about walking on streets of gold. He said they were pure gold, and they were transparent glass. People, again, this is not a fairy tale. We're going to walk on streets of gold. That's part of my compensation plan. When your flesh feels weak, remind yourself that there is a city called heaven. There is a city called heaven somewhere. Back on 40th Street, they used to say, I'm going to make it. It was like, help me to make it. Because there's a city called heaven somewhere. And then the good thing is, the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are going to be the temple. Again, we don't need the sun. We don't need the moon to shine in it, because the glory of God, the glory of God will lighten. So the nations that are saved are going to walk in the light of it. I can go in and out. I don't know what kind of reward, but whatever it is, I throw my crown down at his feet, because I don't deserve it. He makes me worthy. He makes me available. He helps me when I would do wrong. He sits on me. Give me a chair. Just a little chair. You know, it's something about the Holy Ghost. You know, Brother James, you're going to find out. I can't explain it. I just know I got it. So when I would do wrong, the Holy Ghost sits on me. When I really want to give you a piece of my mind, the Holy Ghost sits on me. When I was driving one day, and behind me there was road rage going on, and the gentleman in front of me got out and went to the car behind me, and she rolled her window down, and he spit in that woman's face. The Holy Ghost would sit on me. When my flesh is outraged and inflamed because I watched something I shouldn't have watched. I put my eyes on something I shouldn't have put my eyes on. I heard something I should not have heard. But Holy Ghost, help me. If you cry out to him, he'll help you. He'll sit on you. Sit on you. He'll sit on till you do right. He'll sit on until you act right. He'll sit on till you talk right. He'll sit on till you think right. He'll sit on you. He'll sit on you. And he'll sit on you again. Sit on when you're on the phone. You know, they say AI can almost see you now. So be careful. Be careful what you say. Because AI is listen. I read a book years ago, my first year of college, called George Orwell's 1984. When I tell you that thing is coming to fruition, you almost can't think a thought without somebody picking it up. It's in cyberspace. Did you not know that the supply chain is slow, slower than it's ever been? You know, we waiting on medicine to come. They send it to you in the mail. We better pray. We better build our faith up. So if the medicine don't come, it won't matter, because he who is the healer, he stops by to see me. When I need him, he stops by to heal me. When I want him, he stops by to see me. Woo! Sits on me when I want just get a little gossiping in. You know, it's something about, now I'm just talking to the women. Men, close your ears. You know, we got these 1,500 words. We got to get them out. So when we get home and there's nobody to talk to, well, we gravitate to the phone. You know, and before you know, that's why you got to be careful. Don't talk too long. Because you talk too long, it ain't going to be strong. If you talk too long, it's going to be wrong. Get on the wrong subject. Somebody ought to say, no, we ain't not doing this. That part right there, we not going to do that. We not going to talk that way, because I got a compensation package waiting on me. It's waiting on me in the city called heaven. It's waiting on me. It got my name written on it. Woo. Gates are not going to be shut. I don't have to have a key. I don't have to have a code to get in. If you make it, I hope to see y'all there. Y'all's my brothers and sisters. Y'all's my sisters and brothers. I want to look over and see. Yeah, I'm going to tell you, I do. I want to see my daddy. My God, he died when I was almost 19. I was 19. The youngest was 14 children. He died. My mama was 38 years old. He died. God took him on to glory. And yes, I want to see him, but oh, I want to see Jesus. I want to look upon his face. That'll sing forever of his saving grace. This excites me. I don't know about y'all, but it excites me. And then God has some kind of sense of humor. He tops it off in Revelation chapter 22. And he simply says, behold. You know, behold means stop, look, and listen. He said, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man, woman, according as his works shall be. That's why it's so important to work. Remember, Bishop said the other week that our works do follow us. So you become blessed when you do his commandments. And so now the big question before you this morning is, do you prefer smoking or non-smoking? Do you want smoking? Do you want secondhand smoke? So be careful who you hang out with, because you might get some secondhand smoke that ain't good for you. I want you to know that I'm looking for non-smoking. I'm looking for a city called heaven, city called heaven. I'm going to make it. Care what y'all say. Talk about me if you please. I'm going to make it. I might not look the way you think I should look. You might not want to speak to me. It's all right. Keep it, that part right there. Keep it moving. I am charged with what I do and how I respond. I want the Holy Ghost to just sit on me. Sit on me. When you see something inside of me that moves, when I see that sister, something in me moves and it ain't right, I want you to sit on me, Holy Ghost. Tell me to get myself together, because this don't fit in the Come on, praise team. This don't fit in the city. It don't fit in the city. Glory to God, altar workers, come on. It don't. I'm asking you again, do you prefer smoking or non-smoking? To God be the glory. You prefer smoking? If you prefer non-smoking, just lift your hand up. Look at you. We're getting ready to get out of here. Time is winding up. Time is about to stop. The angels are about to say, blowing the trumpet in Zion, and the dead in Christ gonna rise first. We, which are alive and remain, we're going to be called up to meet him in the air. Stand up, Zion. We made the first step easy for you. Stand up, oh Zion. Yes. This is your opportunity, because soon and very soon, slowly, soon and very soon, we're going to see the King. Slowly. Soon, very, we are going. Might be today. Oh, soon. That's right, young people. God love you. A whole family. My soul says hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you, beloved. Somebody wants to be in the non-smoking section. Hey, hey, hey. Soon we're going.
We are going to see the King.
Oh, soon. Yes, we are going. Where are you, beloved? I love it, these young people. So glad you know. Hallelujah. So glad you know that he's got a compensation package. We're going. That's right. Come on, young people. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Don't you know he loves you? We're going.
We are going to see the King.
More out to work so soon. Yes.
We are going to see the
Hallelujah.
King.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tell him hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
We're going to see the King.
Woo. Thank you for being here, Father. No more dying there. No more dying. No more dying. No more dying. We are
going to see the King.
No more, no more. That's right, baby. He loves you. Yeah.
We are going to see
the King. Yes, let him heal you. Heal you from the inside out. Sister Kathy. Yeah. Sister Kathy. Pull over here. He came to heal that this morning. And where are you this morning? You want to be delivered from that nicotine. I know you're here. God told me you was here. You want to be delivered from that nicotine. Hallelujah. Yes. Yes. healed from the inside out.
God can do it.
He heals from the inside out. Yes.
God can.
Let him have it. Let him have it.
God can do it.
You know that God. Yeah. It's all right, Jonathan. That's all right, baby. He loves you so much. Yes. These young people want to be in the non-smoking section.
Hallelujah.
Where are you? That nicotine is wearing you out. It's wearing you out. Come on now. That's right. That's right. Talk to him. It's the language he gave you to talk to him. Yes, let him clean it. Purify it. Oh, yes. That's all right, young people. Yes, yes. I love it.
I can do it.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Get yours, baby. Get yours. Yes. You know, I always say a little prayer never hurt nobody. Come on and get your, get clean from that nicotine. Well, but my family don't know I smoke. It's all right, honey. Jesus knows. He's here to heal you of that nicotine stuff. He told me, so I know you're here. Come on. And get, you prefer smoking or non-smoking? Come on and get it.
My Lord.
anointing. If you need healing for your body, come on, come on.
He can guide the hands of the soldier.
Yes, it's for those.
He can
non-smoking.
Dear gracious and heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this soul, God. We thank you, Lord, that she's made the decision to go down in your name, God. We ask that you just cleanse her, wash her, and bring her up as white as snow, Lord. And we'll give your name the honor, the glory, and the praise in Jesus' name.
Gabby, what's her last name? Taylor. Gabby Taylor is giving her life to the Lord.
My dearly beloved sister, according to your confession of faith in the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus, of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the confidence which you have in the blessed word of God, I do indeed baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name.
Trouble the water, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hey.
The best decision of his life, oh God. We ask you, oh God, that true repentance has been wrought, Lord Jesus.
Yes,
we ask you that to anoint him, God. Fill him with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
That he may serve you forever. Anoint him in Jesus' name, we pray.
It's the whole family.
My dearly beloved brother, according to your confession of faith in the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the confidence which you have in the blessed word of God, I do indeed baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name.
Trouble the water, Lord, for this family. This is one family.
Hallelujah.
Brother Taylor's grandchildren, his seed. Somebody pray,
Lord,
for them.
Thank you again, Lord, for another soul going down in your name, God.
Yes.
Cleanse her, oh God. Bring her up white as snow. Fill her with the gift of the Holy Ghost, oh God, that she can walk boldly before her peers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
My dearly beloved Raylan Watkins, my granddaughter, according to your confession of faith in the death, burial, and resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the confidence which you have in the word of God, I do indeed baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name.
Trouble the water, Jesus.
Yes, my Lord.
Yes, my Lord.
Yes, my Lord.
Yes, my Lord.
Thank you. precious gift of the Holy Ghost. We thank you, Lord God, he has made the right decision, the best decision of his life, oh God.
Best
him,
decision.
Anoint him. Make him a new creature.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
My dearly beloved grandson, Gary Connor, according to your confession of faith in the death and burial and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the confidence which you have in the word of God, I do indeed baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name.
Trouble the water, Jesus shall say, yeah. This makes number five.
Oh, my Lord.
Oh, yeah.
Just whisper it.
Trustee Bland.
Father God, we thank you again for this soul. We thank you, God, that he has made a decision to go down in your name, to turn his life over,
yes,
to you,
Lord.
God. We ask you, God, that he may be a witness for you, God. Make him a new creature. Make him a witness for you, God. Anoint him in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
My dearly beloved brother, according to the confession of your faith in the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ,
yes,
and the confidence which you have in the blessed word of God,
yes,
I do indeed baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. Amen.
Oh, yeah. Come on, the water, Jesus.
Of your faith in the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the confidence which you have in the blessed word of God, I do indeed baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Amen.
By the water,
trouble the water,
let's go down.
Praise him, honey. You got a blessing. Went down in Jesus' name. He came for somebody today, and they got their deliverance today. Yes, they did. Because God told me, he told me he was going to do it. Yes. Tell him yes. Oh yes, oh yes. Go ahead, Nisi. Yes, my Lord. Yes, yes, my
Lord. Yes, 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 my Lord.
Yes,
yes.
Tell him yes.
Lord.
Yes to his will.
Yes,
yes to his way.
Yes, my Lord.
Yes to his righteousness.
Yes, my Lord.
Yes to his holiness.
Yes, my Lord.
I can't help but say yes.
Yes. This week is the fifth diocese that our pastor is the diocesan bishop over, meets this weekend. The Women's Growth Conference begins on November 17th through 19th. I want you to remember that. Remember to the attire for that weekend. Sneakers on Friday night. Minister Tacola Campbell of Bloomington, Illinois, and Pastor Patricia Germany of Indianapolis, Indiana will be with us, along with other speakers. Also on November 20th, Louisville Unites and our pastor will be honored among others. And Kim Burrell will be the guest and featured singer. We're going to ask you also to remember our Thanksgiving baskets, bringing canned goods and bringing boxed goods. And if you'd like to make donations, please look on Giblify. You will see a tab that says Thanksgiving baskets. We're going to ask you to remember our empowerment lunch, which our assistant pastor is in charge of. The empowerment lunch is every Wednesday at 12 noon. The Council of Men, second and fourth Saturdays from 8:30 to 10. Kingdom Women will meet on December 1st and December 15th. Good God Almighty, I feel good in my sanctified soul. My God. Yes, yes. Woo. Can we put our dismissal confessional up in the blessing of the Lord, make it rich and add it no sorrow. Tell your neighbor, if this is the last time you see my face, know that I have loved the Lord Jesus with all my heart, my soul, my mind, and with all my strength, and my neighbors as myself. I have fought a good fight. I have not been perfect, but I have been pleasing to him. I will see you in the clouds when we meet Jesus in the air. And so, look at that part. So shall we ever be with the Lord. May the Lord bless you. May he keep you. May he smile upon you. May he give you long life. May he supply all your needs according to his riches in glory. And everybody said, and it is so. May God bless you in Jesus' name.
Powerful word we heard today. Before I go, let me just remind you to contact the Connect team if you would like to become a member or have questions about our ministry. We would love to hear from you. Blessings. Have a great week.
Our current live stream schedule is Sunday mornings at 10 o'clock a.m. and Tuesday night Bible class at 7 o'clock p.m. You may watch live on YouTube or Facebook under the Christ Temple Christian Life Center page. Our new prayer line number that is open during both of these services is 1-833-PRAY-CTC. That's 1-833-772-9282. Ways to give: You can download the Givelify app and search for Christ Temple Christian Life Center. You may also give via Cash App, mail your gifts to the church, or you may call Deacon Reed at 502-442-3174 anytime during normal business hours. Here are four simple ways to share this live stream. The easiest is to just click the share button. No matter where we are in the service, this is the fastest way to get our service out to everyone. You can also copy and share the website link by text or email, start a watch party on Facebook, or simply tag three friends in the comment section. Let's stay connected daily through prayer. Join us every morning from 7 to 7:30 a.m. via the Christ Temple CLC Facebook page as we pray together as a church family in unity. And now for this week's announcements. To our Bishop Michael E. Ford Jr., First Lady Andrea Ford, Elder Williams, Pastor Reed, and our entire CTCLC family, there really aren't enough words to express how appreciative we are of the love and support shown us during the passing of our beloved Christopher Mays. Thank you for covering us with much-needed prayer, words of encouragement, flowers, visits, monetary gifts, food, and cards. Great kindness to us. We love you. Thanks for everything from the Mays family. To my CTCLC pastor and church family, the love and with our brother and father while in the hospital and nursing home. And thank you for the food, cards, and other acts of kindness during the loss of our brother and father. May God richly bless each of you. With love, the siblings and entire family of Deacon Lawrence Chandler. There will be a mandatory usher board meeting on Saturday, November the 11th at 12 o'clock noon. All ushers, please plan now to attend. Our annual Thanksgiving food drive is going on now through November 17th. Donations should include canned and boxed goods. For a list of suggested items, please check the email blast. All sisters are invited to our annual Women's Growth Conference, November 17th through the 19th. Register today and let us know you will be attending by downloading the photo frame and posting to social media. Please check the email blast for more details, including our attire for the weekend. Mark your calendars now and plan to invite everyone you know to our Family and Friends Day. Join us on Sunday, November 26th at 10 o'clock a.m. And lastly, have you shared today? If not, go ahead and take this moment to share this live stream with your family and friends. Remember, we are the church. Thank you for your attention, everyone.
Hello, my name is Melissa, a member of the Connect team, and I welcome you to Christ Temple, the house of miracles. Whether you are here in person or online, I hope that you feel the presence of the Lord.